Hey, welcome to Draft Academy. My name's Mike. In this tutorial, I'm going to talk to you guys about return statements in PHP functions. So one of the cool things about functions in PHP is that they allow us to group similar code together that performs specific tasks. So a function is essentially just a container where we can put different lines of code, and then we can reuse that code throughout our programs. And if you've been following along with the course, we kind of looked at the basics of functions in the last tutorial. And one of the things we talked about was how we can give functions information in the form of parameters. So I could actually like give a function a couple of different pieces of information, and then the function can use that information to perform its task. In this tutorial, I want to talk to you guys about another cool thing with functions, which is in addition to us giving functions information in the form of parameters, a function can also give us information back. So if I call a function in my program, not only can I give that function information, but that function can also give information back to me. So it could tell me like, you know, how the function went. It could give me a particular piece of information back. It could pass me back like an array or a variable. It could do all sorts of stuff. So I'm gonna show you guys how we can use returns in PHP functions. So what I wanna do in this tutorial is I'm actually gonna create a function which is gonna cube a number. And whenever we cube a number, you're basically taking it to the power of 3. So if I was to say like 2 raised to the power of 3, that's the same as 2 times 2 times 2, right? This is me cubing a number. And what we want to do is we're going to write a function which will cube a number. So I could pass a number into it and it'll go ahead and cube that number for me. It's going to be a pretty simple function, but this will kind of illustrate the point that I'm trying to get across in this tutorial. So whenever we create a function, we always just want to say function like that. And then we're going to give this a name. So I'm actually going to go ahead and name this function cube because that's what it's doing. It's going to cube a number. I'm going to make an open and close parentheses and an open and close curly bracket. Inside of these open and close parentheses, what I want to do is I want to specify that this function is going to take one parameter. So we're going to allow the user to pass one value into this function, and I'm just going to call it num. So this is going to be the number that we want to cube. And the goal of this function is going to be to take this number, cube it, and then return that value back to the user. So not only are we going to cube the number, but we're also going to return the result of cubing that number back to the user. So this should be pretty cool. All right, so now that we have our function set up, I'm going to go ahead and write the code. So this is actually going to be a pretty simple function. All we really have to do is just cube num. So I can basically just say num times num, right? I mean, essentially by doing this, I'm cubing the number. But here's the problem is I don't just want to cube the number. I want to return the result of cubing the number back to the caller. So whoever calls this function, I want to give this value back to them. And in order to do that, we can use a special word in PHP, which is called return. So I can come over here and just type return. And basically what this is going to do is it's going to return the value that's over here back to the caller. In other words, back to whoever called this function. So if I was to come down here, I could actually call this function and it's going to give me a value back. So I'm going to go ahead and demonstrate that. I'm actually going to create a variable and I'm just going to call it cube result. And I'm going to set it equal to cube. So I'm calling this cube function and I'm gonna pass it a number. So why don't we pass it in a 4? So we're gonna cube 4. And I'm storing the value that gets returned from this cube function inside of this variable. So essentially what happens is when I call this cube function, it goes off, it executes all this code. And when it sees this return keyword, it's basically gonna pass this value back down here. So when I say cube result is equal to cube 4, the value of cubing 4 is gonna get stored inside of this variable. So let me show you guys that. I'm just gonna echo this out. So I'll echo out cube result. And now when I run my program, you guys will see I should get 64 back because 64 is 4 cubed, right? 4 times 4 is 16, 16 times 4 is 64. So essentially what happened was by using this return keyword, I was actually able to get this value. If I got rid of this return keyword, so if I just put this line over here, you'll see that we don't get anything. And that's because nothing was returned from this function. But when I put the return keyword here, then everything works and we're golden. So actually what I could do is I could just cut off the middleman and I could just print this out. So I'm just gonna go ahead and put this in here. And now we're just printing out cube 4, so it's gonna do the same thing, because this is getting a value back when we call that function. So essentially what happens is whenever we put this return keyword in there, it's always gonna be the last line of the function. So whenever PHP is going through and executing this function, whenever it sees this return keyword, it's gonna break out of the function. So let me show you guys. If I was to come down here and say like echo hello, you'd think when I call this cube function that it'll go over here, it'll return this value, and then it'll print out hello, right? But when I run this program, you'll see that we're not printing out hello. This line of code never gets executed. PHP never sees it, never touches it. That's because whenever I put this return keyword in here, this is gonna break us out of the function and we're gonna go back down here. So whenever I say return, that's basically me saying, hey, I'm done with this function. If I was to take this and put this up here above the return keyword, now we're gonna be fine, right? Because over here, it's still printing out hello. That's because I printed this out before that return keyword. So really, you can return any type of value that you want. You could return numbers like I did over here. You could return a string. You could return an array. You could return an associative array. Basically, you can return any, you know, type of information that you want to return using that return statement. You could also just return nothing. So I could just come over here and just say return, and this will still break me out of the function, but it won't return a value. And sometimes people will do that if they just want to kind of like break out of a function. But I'd say for the most part, you're going to be returning information back to the caller. Hey, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like and subscribe to Draft Academy to be the first to know when we release new content. Also, we're always looking to improve, so if you have any constructive criticism or questions or anything, leave a comment below. Finally, if you're enjoying Draft Academy and you want to help us grow, head over to draftacademy.com/contribute and invest in our future.